Welcome all wonders in one sight, eternity shut in a span, summer in winter, day in night, heaven in earth, and God in man. Great little one whose all-embracing birth brings earth to heaven, stoops heaven to earth. Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you, and also with you. Hello, welcome to the Rosendale team's online worship this week, the fourth Sunday of Advent, Christmas Eve. How very exciting. My name is Janet, and it is wonderful that you are here worshipping with us. Welcome. Now, maybe this Advent you've been joining us here online, maybe you've been in one of our nine churches, maybe you've heard carols singing out in the community, there's been so much going on, and you've found yourself with questions of like, what is that about? Well, we'd like to invite you to something special. In the new year, we're running an alpha course online. Let me put some details up on the screen for you. Alpha's going to start on January the 16th at 7:30 over on Zoom, so we don't have to worry about the wonderful Rosendale winter weather. And it's going to be a place where you can ask all the questions you've got about faith. Or you can just come and listen, just take it all in. Maybe this Advent you've heard something at a carol service or here online, something that you've been pondering. Alpha's a really good place to wrestle with all that, to get to grips with all that, to really think about what faith might mean for you. If you want to know more, Rod's email is going to be below the video today. Just let him know and he'll send you the Zoom link. So please do join us if you've been having questions, if you know someone that's been asking you questions, whether you're new to faith, have no faith, or even have been a Christian for quite a while, but you want to dig into things a little bit more. Alpha is a really safe, good space to explore all the questions that we've got. So let's have our first hymn. Let's sing Angels from the Realms of Glory.
From the realms of glory, wing your flight over all the earth. He who sang creation's story, now proclaim Messiah's birth. Come and worship Christ the newborn King. Come. Suddenly the Lord is descending in his temple shall appear. Come and worship Christ the newborn King. Come and worship, worship Christ the
this day, on this Christmas Eve, let us turn back to God and say sorry and seek his forgiveness. Christ, the light of the world, has come to dispel the darkness of our hearts. In his light, let us examine ourselves and confess our sins. God, our Father, you sent your Son full of grace and truth. Forgive our failure to receive him. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Jesus, our Saviour, you were born in poverty and laid in a manger. Forgive our greed and rejection of your ways. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Spirit of love, your servant Mary responded joyfully to your call. Forgive the hardness of our hearts. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May the God of all healing and forgiveness draw you to himself, that you may behold the glory of his Son, the Word made flesh, and be cleansed from all your sins. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And in God's loving forgiveness, let's share in his peace. Glory to God in the highest, and peace on earth to all on whom his favour rests. The peace of the Lord be always with you, and also with you. It's time for our reading now, and our team rector, Rod, is going to read from the book of Luke for us.
Reading from Luke chapter 1, verses 26 to 38. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favoured one. The Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favour with God. Now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. Now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. This is the sixth month for her who is said to be barren, for nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." And the angel departed from her.
I want us to think back for a minute to January 2023, back to the beginning of this year. What were we expecting would happen this year? Maybe some of us were expecting to go on holiday. Maybe some of us were expecting to start a new job or a new college. Maybe some of us were expecting to have an operation. Maybe some of us were expecting another Prime Minister by Easter. Were there things in 2023 that we didn't expect? A promotion at work? A visit from an old friend? An accident or illness? Life always throws unexpected things in our way. Just look at today's passage from Luke. Here, Luke mentions two women, Mary and Elizabeth, neither of whom expected to find themselves where they did. Indeed, the nativity story is full of unexpectedness. How many people can we think of in the nativity story? Zechariah, Elizabeth, Mary, Joseph, angels, shepherds, magi, Herod. What were they all expecting before the birth of Jesus? Zechariah and Elizabeth were most definitely not expecting that Elizabeth would have a baby. They hadn't been able to have children and they were getting older. Yet the angel Gabriel visits Zechariah and tells him Elizabeth will bear a son and that this son will be great in the sight of the Lord. Their son is born and grows to become John the Baptist. Mary and Joseph were expected to be married and live their lives as countless others did, quietly getting on with, you know, an okay living, raising a family, the normal stuff. They didn't expect Mary to be pregnant before they were wed or to be visited by an angel to tell them the baby she carried was more special than they could begin to imagine. The shepherds out on the hills, they expected to be tending their sheep, protecting them as they always did. The last thing they expected was for a whole host of angels to fill the sky and tell them to go down to Bethlehem to find a very special baby. The Magi, now they were expecting something special. They'd seen a star, and to them, that spoke of a new ruler, someone of great importance been born. So they set out to see for themselves. But they expected to find a new ruler in a palace, and that's why they popped in to see Herod. And he was most definitely not expecting some random travellers to knock on his door and tell him a new king had been born. But when the Magi left Herod, did they expect to find this new king lying in a manger? Each of the people I've just mentioned encountered things they really didn't expect. And yet, Zechariah and Elizabeth are described by Luke as righteous before God. They loved and served the Lord. They, like thousands of others, would have been waiting, would have been expecting God to act to save his people. The shepherds would have had this expectation too, and it's hard not to think something pretty special is happening if a sky full of angels should appear before you. Even Herod, horrified to hear that a child had been born, which these travellers were calling King of the Jews, he's horrified because he knows what God's people have been expecting, and he wants no talk of such a rival. Mary and Joseph, two ordinary people, they're chosen by God. God sends his messenger to tell them how favoured they are in his sight, and their response is strikingly powerful, one full of expectation of God's faithfulness. Joseph is an honourable man, and even though he finds Mary is pregnant before they are married, he wants to protect her as much as he can. When an angel appears to him, in a dream, telling him not to be afraid, to take Mary as his wife, he does not hesitate to heed the angel's words. Mary, a young girl, speaks to an angel who fills her heart with words she would have never expected to hear. She is told incredible, marvellous things. How to take them in, how to respond. I am the Lord's servant. May your word to me be fulfilled. I am the Lord's servant. The people we hear about in the Nativity story might have been expecting God to act, might have been waiting to see how God would fulfill his promise to his people. But I wonder, was this more of an abstract anticipation? They knew what they'd been taught. God would act. Yes, 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 we know. I'm not sure any of them expected God would act in their time, though, that they would be so intimately involved. How do we expect God will act in our lives? What do we anticipate of how God will be at work here and now in our time? When my son was born, I would have said I was an atheist. But having a child changed everything. The experience was so profound, I couldn't stop wondering, well, there's got to be more, hasn't there? There's got to be something bigger than this. I began to investigate various philosophies, Buddhism, Taoism. They all had a reputation for being pretty wise, didn't they? It never crossed my mind to look at Christianity. There was no expectation on my part that I'd find any answers there at all. That obviously turned out to be a fairly bad assessment. C.S. Lewis said, "I believe in Christianity as I believe that the sun has risen, not only because I see it, but because by it I see everything else." When I finally realised Jesus had been right by my side all along, that's exactly what I found out. Once I recognised Jesus, as unexpected as that was, everything else suddenly made sense. And my response? "Here I am, Lord. Let's go." 2024 will have in store lots of things we don't expect. But we can, with absolute certainty, expect one thing. Because of a baby born over 2,000 years ago, because of all he came to do, God will be with us. In all the good stuff, all the bad stuff, all the humdrum stuff, God will be with us. He will be with us in all that we expect will happen. He will be with us in all we never saw coming in a million years. God will be with us. How will we respond knowing that? Will we, like Zechariah and Elizabeth, like the shepherds, like the Magi, like Mary and Joseph, respond with, "Thank you, Lord. Here we are." Amen. With thankful, expectant hearts, let us share our faith in our loving God. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us, and rose again? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world? We believe and trust in him. This is the faith of the church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. And now Samuel, our other team vicar, is going to lead our prayers.
Let us pray. Holy, merciful and heavenly Father, we give you thanks for this time and opportunity you have given us, that although we are in different places, we still come together to worship your glorious name. We bless your name for every blessing which you have showered on us. Gracious Father, we thank you for this important and significant day that you have given us, and we can celebrate the joys of Christmas. Although we are not worthy and not better than those who could not see this day, but this is your parental compassion and kindness that you gave us this opportunity. Today is a very important and a sacred day, not just for the Christians all around the world, but for all mankind, because you came into the world in human flesh to save your creation. As today we celebrate the birth of your Son, our Savior, in human flesh, Father, we pray that accept our praises and celebration in your presence and help us so that we can convey the real meaning of Christmas to the world. Gracious Lord, we come to you at this time to pray for all those who are suffering in mind, body, and spirit. Heavenly Father, when your Son Jesus was on this earth in human form, he healed many sick and cured many souls with his might, strength, and power. We believe that you still have the same strength and power that you had in your Son 2,000 years ago. We lift all those people and pray, God, that stretch and extend your healing hand. Touch them, cure their sickness, and be with them in their difficult times and problems, so that they may feel your presence in their life. Dear Lord, remember all those people and families whose loved one have fallen asleep in you this year, and this Christmas is their first Christmas without their loved ones. O Lord, you are the all source, the main source of comfort and consolation, and we can find that only in you. We pray that at this time of distress, God be with all these people and families, give them comfort and concord that we cannot give them as human beings in this difficult time. So your glory will reflect from their life through this Christmas. Heavenly Father, as we know, celebrating the joy of the coming of your Son who came to this world as a Prince of Peace, by giving his life on the cross, he preached the message of peace and reconciliation to the world. Father, we ask this time especially for the countries that are in the state of war. We pray for the reconciliation between Ukraine and Russia, Israel and Hamas, and a peace agreement with these countries according to your holy word. Dear Lord, we also pray for all those places that are affected with any other adversity. We pray for all those countries that are facing problems in the form of earthquakes, volcano eruptions, floods, fires, starvation, famine, or any other climate change adversity. Lord, at their difficult time, be there with them in their hardships, and bless all those people who are supporting and helping them. Merciful Father, at this time we also give you thanks that you have established your church in this world, especially here in the Rosendale Valley. Lord, we pray that here in this part use your church as a beacon of light and a channel of your love to others. Dear God, use your church as an instrument in your hand to glorify your name through its actions and deed. Also pray for the clergy serving here. Lord, support and strengthen them in your word so they may guide your flock diligently and earnestly. Lord, remember all those people who are struggling financially, and it is very difficult for them to warm up their houses at this time. And they are also struggling to provide for their families. Lord, be their provider and manifest your love for your creation through their lives. At this time, we also pray for all political leaders, all those who are in authority, all the policy makers, that this Christmas time they may work wholeheartedly to serve this country under your mighty hand. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
The Collector's Special Prayer for Christmas Eve. Almighty God, as we prepare with joy to celebrate the gift of the Christ child, embrace the earth with your glory and be for us a living hope. In Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And let's say together the prayer Jesus has taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Thank you for being with us on Christmas Eve to worship, to give praise and thanks on this edge of expectation, this anticipation of all that is to come. So Rod, Samuel and me, we wish you a happy and blessed Christmas. Let's sing our final song, Ding Dong Merrily on High.
Chimey ring us, may you beautifully rhyme your eve time song.
May the Father, who has loved the eternal Son from before the foundation of the world, shed that love upon you, his children. Amen. May Christ, who by his incarnation gathered into one things earthly and heavenly, fill you with joy and peace. Amen. May the Holy Spirit, by whose overshadowing Mary became the God-bearer, give you grace to carry the good news of Christ. Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.